Beethoven String Trio in D, Opus 902. In the late 18th century, when Beethoven composed his three string trios, Opus 9, he was still in the process of establishing himself as a respected composer in Vienna. He had gained recognition as a talented pianist, performing his own music and improvising in significant venues. His reputation increased further after three concerts at the Burgtheater in 1795, where he showcased his skills and played his B-flat major piano concerto for the first time. Building on his success in Vienna, Beethoven embarked on concert tour, visiting cities like Berlin, Pressburg, and Dresden in 1796. It was hard for Beethoven as a composer to escape the shadow of Mozart and Haydn. He faced challenges in establishing his own identity. Although Mozart had died in 1791, he was more popular than ever after he died. Mozart's divertimento in E flat major for string trio was published in 1792. It was an inspiration for Beethoven's trios. Beethoven studied under Haydn for about a year upon arriving in Vienna. Haydn was very influential. His achievements in symphonies and string quartets are believed to have influenced Beethoven, leading him to focus on piano sonatas and chamber music like string trios during the 1790s. The second trio from Beethoven's Opus 9 set is in four movements, following the structure commonly found in Haydn's quartets and symphonies. The following takes an important role in the trio. The first movement, Allegretto, showcases strong lyrical quality in the following part, while the accompanying instruments create a restless atmosphere. The second movement, characterized by its flowing 6/8 rhythm and minor key, evokes the feeling of a mysterious dance. The third movement is a lively minuet. It reminds listeners that Beethoven would soon move away from courtly dances, favoring the more energetic scherzo. In the Rondo finale, Beethoven gives the main melody to the cello, but the violin takes over by the end. Please enjoy.